proposal. Our news director, Jules Vasquez, has been following the work behind the scenes, and he joins us live on set. Jules, welcome to 2024.
Thank you.
Jules, before...
Good night.
Good night. Before
we're
we get
information, sorry.
So that's okay. Before we get into the real heart of the issue about the agreement that was or that is currently being hammered out, tell us a little bit about how today started, how it evolved, what was the tipping point in it, and how we are here right now tonight.
Well, as you all have seen in the news so far, the Prime Minister was forced to cancel his vacation. He was on personal leave, followed by an official visit with the Pope at the Vatican. Which is not a thing easily cancelled. This is reminiscent of 2013 when you will remember they had the big rock run up the street with the George Street gang, and the Prime Minister, Dean Barrow at the time, had to cancel an official trip in the Caribbean to return. So I'm just saying, it's not every day a Prime Minister cancels his trip, but a trip in to see the Pope is significant. He had to cancel it, he had to come back. He's extremely disappointed, he said that. And because when he left on Saturday, the deal was there.
Right.
But, and he was sure they would sign it.
Okay.
It was to be signed at 9 a.m. on Saturday. But it was really a nothing deal. Why is it a nothing deal? Because there is nothing that the Cane Farmers Association wanted in it. They were going to get not the fair trade royalties, or fair trade premium, sorry, and not the waiver of the throughput. Why? Because the other associations, the other three associations, do not have these features in their agreements. So we cannot give you preferential treatment, is what ASR-BSI is saying. So it was a nothing deal for the BSCFA, and it was like, well, you got to take it. That's what's on the table.
Right.
Prices are high. That's the deal. Prices are high, and your cash, you know, prices are at a record high, the price you're going to get for your sugar. But they rejected it. And the Prime Minister basically left the Minister of Agriculture, who is the Orange Walks Out representative in charge. But you saw what happened to him today. Then people no one hear that. Then people vex, and it's a particular kind of anger because they are disappointed in the PUP. The PUP controls the North, 7 of 8 seats in the North. And they are of the North.
Of course.
So the Norteños are very disappointed in their government.
How it's happening to them.
For not delivering. So Jose Mai raced back to meet with the Prime Minister. The Prime Minister has been constantly on the phone with ASR-BSI and the principals from BSCFA. So now...
What's in the agreement?
So now there's a counter-proposal.
Right.
And the counter-proposal is, the sticking point is what are called throughput and terminal charges.
Right.
BSCFA refuses to pay that. They say that should not be there. ASR-BSI says it has to be there.
Mm-hmm.
The point is, the Prime Minister's counter-proposal is that you waive that for 3 months.
Okay.
You waive that for 3 months while enter Hugh O'Brien. Hugh O'Brien is the chairman of BAHA. I believe he's respected in agricultural circles.
Mm-hmm.
He's a noted agronomist. So you bring in Hugh O'Brien as the good faith go-between. He will investigate these charges for 3 months to see if they are justified. After 3 months, he will submit his findings. Then we can have another round of talks to see if they are justified. If they are not justified, then we have to go into another type of negotiation. However...
Is this what is coming out now?
That's right now.
Okay, this is it.
However, as I understand it, this is what Joe Marie is telling us, that the other feature of the agreement is that it be a 3-year rollover agreement. So after 2 years, the commission of inquiry that government sets up will report. And regardless of what the report says, it rolls over into 3 years. But after that 2-year finding, you can do another... examination of the agreement, but it's going to roll over into 3 years anyway.
Right.
It's going to roll over into 3 years anyway. I understand Joe Marie, she's out at CIRDE right now with the cane farmer. She said they rejected it.
Okay.
She said that the proposal for 3 years, they want only two.
Okay.
And they will only settle for 2 years. They will not sign a 3-year agreement, which ASR BSI started out at 4 years.
Right.
So ASR BSI is saying that they must have a three-year agreement. So now, right now, Joe is saying that they gave them an hour. They gave the government side an hour. And I want to stress that. So right now, things are paused, but very tense. We have tire fires. Guys, I think we have footage of the tire fires that I sent earlier. This is on the San Victor Road. Are we able to bring that up?
When was this?
Mr. Baird, I think we have footage of it.
When was this?
The footage of the tire fires. That was just an hour ago. Yeah. So we'll bring that up shortly, but there are tire fires in the north. And it's only one, and it was put out quickly. But it was just discovered around sunset. If we can bring that up now. Yeah. Okay, so let's bring it up now. All right, so we have that, yeah. So this is the road behind San Victor, and you see the police went there and they put out the
fire.
They put out the fire.
A small one, but still not a good indicator of anything.
Yeah, I think we have more images of it, but it's a small one, but it's not a good sign.
No.
Things remain very tense. There's great anger and antipathy towards the government. These are people who supported the PUP. And remember that if me and you are a team, that
right.
I support you, the disappointment is a different
Deep.
Kind
different.
Of disappointment. This government is a Norteño government. I'll repeat, 7 of 8 seats in the north, and there is a profound, there are heavy expectations and profound disappointment.
So,
because what the BSEFA is saying, government, use your executive will to force ASRBS and government
right,
is saying
so
they cannot. This is a foreign-owned company. It is it is the largest sugar refiner in the world. In the world, they're an American company. They're a multinational. The government cannot go there and say, do X, Y, Z.
Right. So, Jules, what's the social and political context of this zooming out?
Well, I think, as you know, as we've been saying, it's a Norteño issue.
Right.
And I think that, you know, for years, the BSEFA has had such a strong control in the north, and they no longer do because they have more associations now. And so it's like a former heavyweight boxer.
Losing.
You know, he's still going into the ring, throwing haymakers, but he doesn't have the power he once had.
Losing the power
bit. Right. But it's a political emergency for the PUP. And that's why the Northern Caucus put out a statement yesterday agreeing with them that they should waive these throughput charges, agreeing with the farmers that BSI should waive the throughput charges. This is not the agreement their own party leader and prime minister negotiated. The Northern Caucus, of which the Prime Minister is the most important member, the PUP Northern Caucus is saying, I know that the agreement which our leader negotiated did not have any waiver for the throughput, but we support the throughput. Now, I understand
that's an issue.
It's politics. But I understand it's politics. But yes, it's an issue. It's
it's
indicative of a type of fracturing.
Mm-hmm.
And later in the segment, you'll hear a little more of that. Later in the segment, you'll hear a little more of that from Henry Charles Usher, who gave a really remarkable statement on the PUP morning show today. But so right now, you know, they gave them an hour, and we are seeing what the government will come back with. But they want it not to be a 3-year rollover agreement. They want it to be a 2-year agreement.
Have they agreed to the part of having
it seems that they have
okay.
Yes, they have, and it seems that they've agreed to waive the shipping the throughput and terminal charges for 3 months now. ASRBSI explained those charges, and that will be coming up shortly. But so that's where we are right now. Joe Marie remains out there.
Thanks.
And so Joe Marie remains out there, so any breaking
any
news, we're going to have it.
Okay,
yeah.
Perfect. Thank you.
Thank you
so much. And thanks for that update.